Hi, I'm working as a customer success manager at Sumo Logic. I'll show you how to monitor infrequent data tier usage using Sumo Logic's built-in infrequent data tier application. Let's consider a scenario where I have set up the debug logs to be stored in one or multiple partitions of the infrequent tier. I need to know how much credits I am consuming every day and what percentage of tier is used per user. Can Sumo Logic help me? The answer is yes, using the Infrequent Data Tier app. This app has visually intuitive, pre-configured dashboards. The app provides visibility into the usage and credits consumed by queries run against data in the infrequent tier. Let me show you how the built-in application dashboards help in monitoring the data usage and credit consumption. The Data Scanned Overview dashboard provides visibility into the total amount of data scanned by infrequent queries. This allows me to monitor on-demand search costs for the infrequent tier. I can use this dashboard to monitor data scan information per day. I can also analyze monthly comparisons of scanned data. This panel would provide a breakup of queries performed on partition in the infrequent data tier by query status like successful or failed, query aggregation, and, eventually, query type, such as scheduled searches, views, and so on. Next is the Data Scanned by Users dashboard, which provides insights into the amount of infrequent data scanned by specific users, user trends, and the geographic locations of users. As an administrator, I can use this dashboard to see which users have queried the infrequent tier most, and the geographic locations from which users have run queries against the infrequent tier. Additionally, it helps me to analyze trends in the data scanned by users over a 30-day period. The Query Analysis dashboard provides visibility into the infrequent data tier queries that are consuming the most number of credits, as well as detailed information on the queries. This dashboard helps me to identify the most expensive queries on the infrequent tier and analyze queries executed against infrequent tier. Finally, the Credits Consumed dashboard provides visibility into the total count of Cloud Flex credits my organization has consumed with infrequent queries. This allows me to monitor on-demand search costs for the infrequent tier. I can use this dashboard to monitor credits consumed per day and monitor credits consumed per user. So, to summarize quickly, the infrequent data tier application is helpful in monitoring the scanned data, analyzing queries, and viewing the credits consumed. For more information, please refer to the Sumo documentation here. I hope this video helps you get started with Sumo Logic's infrequent data tier application. Thank you for joining.